black sunglasses, black leather jacket.
It's cool.
You gotta be suave. You gotta be, you know, Sam Payne? Sam Payne is cool. Because Sam Payne doesn't care about what other people think about Sam. Me, on the other hand, sometimes I'm cool. Sometimes when I wear a trench coat, I feel cool. When I'm biking and in the wind, then I'm cool.
I guess for me, I think coolness kind of is determined by what we enjoy doing. Because if I look at a violinist, a professional, let's say Heifetz, one of the best of all time, if not the best, playing some incredibly difficult piece, I find that super cool because it's a master of a craft that I personally enjoy as a violinist, playing at the peak of their like repertoire and at such a high level. But I think a lot of people will look at that and be like, it's just another piece of classical music, it's dumb. But I might say, oh, that guy scored, I don't know, 3 touchdowns and threw 4 field goals. That doesn't make sense. I don't know football. But I don't find that cool. Other people is like, that's amazing. That's super cool. So it does really, to me, depend on who's being asked the question and what they enjoy doing.
Oftentimes, unless you're like incredibly cocky or self-absorbed, like you're not gonna think of yourself as like a cool person, but you view like other people as like a cool person. Somebody who's just like good like friend to have. I don't need like people who are gonna be like doing all these like risky things for me to think of them as cool. You know, I think you're a cool person. I think like all our friends are cool people, you know.
I think like in a social perception of them, like based on these movies and stuff and like pop culture that we've had to define us, I do think that they're like, there's an overlap there.
Mm-hmm.
Like I think when we think about cool people, they're also people that are typically more popular. Mm-hmm. But again, in real life, like the people that I find cool aren't necessarily people that everybody would find cool. I think people are cool when they're like well-read and like I can have a conversation with them about like their interests and stuff like that. I think that's really cool. I think it just comes back to like our individual taste. I think it's less of like a joint communal thing and more of like person to person.
You want to fit in, you want to be like normal, be cool, be like other people. And then you realize that like everyone feels that way, and that's just kind of a very like cyclical universal feeling.
So like all my friends from elementary school, we went to middle school and like combined with another school, and that's to make our middle school, and that's when they started caring a lot about like what's cool and what isn't cool. And I don't know, I wanted to be friends with them because we've been friends since kindergarten. So I remember like middle school was a lot of like trying to fit in and be cool and stuff. So around like ninth grade, I realized like I did not like that at all. And so then I like went and made new friends that I liked a lot better, which is funny because I think in like that group in middle school, I was like the really shy kid, like, and it was like a lot more awkward in the group. And then like now that I have friends that I like, a lot of them, not to be conceited or anything, but like we'll say I'm cool. I like, and I'm like a lot more outgoing and confident and happy.
Okay. So what does the word cool mean to you?
What does the word cool mean to me? It means something different from what I think it was originally meant to me, because I think originally it meant like unemotional or unruffled or unflappable, you know, so someone who was in a way kind of cold is sort of what the word meant originally, I think. You know, if you were cool, I think it's come to mean what hip used to mean, that sort of thing. The field of literature that I specialize in, that I study most, I think is the coolest and has most to say about what's cool. And this is modernist literature, which was the sort of experimental, unconventional kind of literature that really tried to make a difference and change the culture. So writers like James Joyce and Virginia Woolf, or Gertrude Stein is another one. Writers like Ernest Hemingway and Zora Neale Hurston. In their day, I think they seemed to be coolest because they were striking out new directions.
At the end of the day, being cool is all about being confident. Whether you're a dancer, a teacher, athlete, musician,
or Samuel Penn,
it's all about owning who you are as a person. So confidence is key. That's cool.
Okay.
Don't tell your mother. Kiss one another. Die for each other.
We're cool for the summer.
She's so old.
Take me down into the paradise.
Hey, scary, cause I'll do body time. Just something that we wanna try. Cause you and I, we're cool for the summer.